to the one and only Lenny. Hello, guys. What the heck is up? Happy New Year. Try and set you down here. Let me reposition this too. I've got like my bad water bottle here today. Okay. I honestly can't believe it's a new year. I don't know about you guys. 2019 went so freaking fast for me. I'm ready for 2020. I've got my planner, but I went to Glen Edith this morning so that I could map out all of my goals and just figure out what I wanted to talk to you guys about in this video. So this morning at Glen Edith, I was mapping out just everything. And I actually talked about it in, was it the last YouTube video I uploaded? I talked about my journal in 2019 and how at the beginning I like to put like all of my stats and stuff, my starting place, and then I will go into my goals for that year and then my list of accomplishments, all of that stuff. If you guys wanna go check out that video, I will include it right here for you guys. Is this crooked? There's so much that I feel like I want to update you guys on. The first big thing, my office, I finally painted it. Alex and I bought this house in 2017, October of 2017, and ever since then, we've just been working away on little house projects. So some of the rooms that we painted first, like our living room was green, our spare bedroom upstairs was lime green. We worked on painting the rooms that we didn't love, and my office, you guys know the color of it. It was more so a tan-ish color, and it was okay. It was neutral. I didn't really mind it that much, but I have been wanting to paint my office for a very, very long time, mainly because of video quality, as well as everything else in my room is very cool-toned, and then I had warm-toned walls, and it just didn't really work. So, in terms of video quality, actually, I am planning on filming a YouTube video this month, talking a little bit more about that, so maybe I won't even discuss it in this video, but my office is painted. We got a brand new office for 2020. It's not a brand new office, but still newer to me. And I'm so excited. I absolutely love it. Alex keeps messing with me that it's just white, but you can tell in the video that's not white compared to the door. I mean, anyways, okay. In this video, we're going to be talking about 2020, goal setting, my goals for this year, and what goals, not really what goals I think you guys need to set for yourself, but how to set better goals for yourself. Now, I'm hoping that you already set your goals for the new year because this is being uploaded on January 1st. So I'm really hoping that you already have kind of mapped out your plan for this year, but if you haven't, that's totally okay, and I just kind of want to walk you through my thought process and how I think you really should set your goals for this year. So this video is going to be a little bit more of a chatty one, and then the next video I'm going to upload, we're going to be back to my normal style. You guys know, jumping around, getting different scenes, taking a look at my analytics. I'm very, very excited for all of my video ideas that I have coming this year, so I'm really pumped. But in terms of setting goals, I thrive off of goal setting. I'm not sure what it is, but I freaking love it. So whether it's a new year, a new month, honestly, the new start to a week like Monday, I'm there for it. I love setting goals. I love a fresh start. And I know it's just like a lot of, it's kind of like your mentality. You know, you can take a Wednesday and start something new. That's great. But if you wake up in the morning, you're like, today I'm going to do this, freaking do it. So I like the start of a new year as just like a fresh start, as well as a good milestone to keep track of where you're at, where you've been, and where you're going. So this morning I did go to Glen Edith and I brought my new notebook. I love this thing. It's soft and it's sparkly. And I wrote down where I am currently at with all of my stats in terms of, got Instagram, YouTube, email, my paid products and courses. I've got the growth that happened this year. So if you guys are curious, I gained 3,600 new followers on Instagram. I gained 39,000 subscribers on YouTube. I gained 1,700 new email subscribers, and I had 280 sales in my paid products. And then I also have the monetary amount there. I also wrote down all of my paid products, how many people have them right now, the money I've earned from my paid products, and then I wrote down my goals. So here's the deal. Let's go through like my list, my recommendations on how you guys should set goals. The very first thing I think you need to do, actually, let me do a little plug here, a little promo. I don't do this too often, but you guys know that I came out with my blow it up blueprint. This is really the strategy that I follow when I am coming up with my goals. And I really recommend, if you guys struggle with coming up with your goals, get this, because this is the exact outline that I follow step by step. It's honestly, it's more in detail, but it's just a blank workbook that walks you through everything, and it is a game changer. So I'm not going to go over everything that's included in this, but if you guys want, please get this. It is included down below. But the very first thing you need to do, you really need to understand where you're at right now and what happened over the last year. And that's one of the reasons why in the back of my journal every single year, I keep a list of accomplishments. And that really just keeps things in perspective for me. So it helps me to understand where I got started, where I'm at now, and what I can actually accomplish in a year. Because when I first started my blog, my brand, I really thought that the first year I was gonna be able to leave my job, work for myself full time. I thought that I was gonna have 50,000 followers on Instagram. I still don't even have that. And I had some other really, really crazy goals for myself. So that was in 2017. 2018, I set more crazy goals. I wanted to hire my first like assistant or first employee. I still haven't done that. I wanted to make $100,000 a year. Again, I still haven't done that. And I used to set these ridiculous, ridiculous goals for myself because I didn't really understand my starting point and what I could truly accomplish in a year. And that's why in this journal for 2020, I put what I was able to do in 2019 so I could have a better understanding of what I could actually achieve in 2020. So figure out your starting point. That's gonna help you a lot. Now, if you are a brand new YouTuber, because actually my last giveaway that I did for hashtag TCB Christmas, I asked you guys to submit your goals. Tell me what your goals were, and that's how you could be entered in the giveaway. And a lot of people said that they wanted to start a YouTube channel. So I understand a lot of you are either beginners, you've got maybe 500 subscribers or less, or a lot of you haven't even got started yet. And I don't want you guys to say, my goal for 2020 is to start my YouTube channel and to have 100,000 subscribers. That's not a really realistic goal. Is it possible? 100%. It's possible, but that's not a realistic goal. And I don't want you guys to set goals that are too far away that you can't actually achieve them and that you feel a bit unmotivated to actually get there. So if you are just now starting your YouTube channel, I really think your first year, if you hustle hard, you focus on actually using the right strategies, things that I've shared in my YouTube videos, I think you can reach 1,000 to 10,000 subscribers this year. So I think that's pretty realistic, 1,000 to 10,000 subscribers. And with that, I would say work on becoming monetized this year. Now, if you are so focused on, I need 1,000 subscribers, I need to hit my 4,000 watch hours, and I need to become monetized on YouTube, there are other ways that you can start making money. And I've talked about that before. If you guys want to get started with affiliate marketing, which I think is the first way you should monetize your brand, I'm going to include a video right here for you guys because I think you should check that out, especially if you're getting started in 2020. But realistically, if you're starting from zero, 1,000 to 10,000, set your goals within that range. And then when it comes to the monetary goals that you want to set for yourself, keep it realistic again. Your first year, you're probably not going to be able to work for yourself full time. You're not going to make that $100,000 a year. You know, you're not going to have six figures, but you can start to make decent money. So you just need to be practical with yourself. So figure out your starting point, be really practical. And honestly, guys, please check out my blow it up blueprint because this goes over an evaluation, things you really need to work on, and it helps you to set more short-term goals that are going to then lead to your long-term goals. Now, the second part of this YouTube video, I really want to talk about the goals that I've set for myself in 2020, my plans for this year. You guys are really invested in my growth and you guys want to know what I want to do with my brand, and I think that that is freaking amazing. So I've talked about it in a couple of other videos in the past, but more specifically, I just kind of want to go over my goals for this year, my intentions, things I hope to achieve, and like things that are on my to-do list, things that I want to do. So the first thing that I did, so I put my starting point of everything like I already talked about. The next thing that I did, I actually wrote down some goals for 2022. And that may seem a little weird, but I wanted to really hone in on my big picture. Like, what are the things that I want to achieve in the next 2 to 3 years? So I ended up writing down, how many things do I got here? I got 10 things here that I want to achieve by 2022. And a lot of them are really, really big. Some of them are personal, but that's what I did to then better understand, okay, what do I actually want to achieve this year? It's good to have the big picture and then be able to break it down and be like, okay, these are my stepping stones to get to the point where I want to be. I like to write 5 goals. So this year, my first goal is an income related goal. So I want to hit my first $10,000 month, meaning I want to make $10,000 with my passive income in 1 month. That's a goal I haven't ever hit before. And I also want to make more than $100,000 this year. So if you think about it, that's basically most months I'll be making $10,000 or more if I want to hit that $100,000, unless one of my months is just like absolutely insane and I make buku bucks, but we'll see what happens. So $10,000 a month, and I want to hit $100,000 this year in income. I want to land at least 500 sales on my paid products this year. That's my second goal. Third goal, guys, I really thought that in 2020, I was gonna hit 100,000 subscribers on YouTube. And I was like, yes, 2020, I'm gonna get my plaque. I'm gonna hit 100,000 subscribers. But with the growth of my YouTube channel, I've been hitting 10,000 new subscribers every 15 to 20 days. So if I set a goal of 100,000 subscribers right now with the growth of my brand, I know that I can achieve that. And I wanna set goals that are, I feel like, are still a little out of my reach. So I have to work really hard for them. So I ended up bumping up that goal to 200,000 subscribers on YouTube. And I think that's pretty attainable. My Instagram goal, I want to have 25,000 followers on Instagram. That is the biggest growth that I will ever see in a year if I do achieve that goal, which I'm going to achieve that goal. But that will be the biggest growth that I've ever seen on Instagram. And I know that may seem a little dramatic. YouTube, 200,000 compared to 25,000 on Instagram. But YouTube is clearly my most successful platform right now. And not everyone on YouTube is going to go to my Instagram. So I think that's a pretty realistic way to break that up. My fourth goal, I want to get paid to speak at least one big conference this year. Last year, I spoke at my first conference ever. This year, I think I'm going to speak at multiple. At least my goal would be to speak at like two conferences, but I want to be paid a decent amount of money to speak at one big conference this year. My fifth goal, you guys already know that I want to do this in 2020. I want to start building out my team. So I want to hire at least one person. And then I wrote down a little bit more because I don't think a good goal is to say, okay, I'm gonna hire someone. That's like a yes or no, whether I do it or not. I think there needs to be a little bit of unknown in terms of goal setting. And that's actually something included in the Blow It Up Blueprint, is how to set goals instead of projects for yourself. But I want to be able to hire an employee to help me with emails, brand deals, and future opportunities to hopefully increase my income every month by $2,000. So whatever I'm making right now or before I hire someone on, I want them to be able to help me get to the next level and make $2,000 additional dollars every single month. Then some other thoughts for 2020, because this is something that I really, really recommend you guys do. I do think it's good to set, I wouldn't say monetary goals, more so like number goals that you want to hit, you know, certain stats you want to hit, or like I'm starting out here, I'm going to be there. You guys understand what I'm saying here, but I think it's also good to have personal intentions and things you just really want to focus on every day that year, or try to focus on every day that year. So here are some other thoughts that I have for 2020. Time spent on yourself is never a waste of time. And this is something that I was actually talking to Alex about yesterday. When I go to the gym, I'll only give myself a half hour to 40 minutes. And then I'm like, okay, that's enough time. I need to get home. I need to start working. And I think it's really because of the growth within my brand right now. There's more work to do than ever before. And I'm just feeling a lot of pressure to be working, working, working. And I want to get back to the point where I'm comfortable taking time for myself. Like, that is never a waste of time. And the more I work on myself, the more other things in my life are going to bloom as well. So that's really one thing that I want to focus on this year. Fall back in love with the process. I'm a little bit embarrassed to admit this, just because I always preach that you need to be in love with what you're doing, you need to have a passion for it, and you shouldn't really be focused on the numbers. But I think over time, as my channel has grown, you guys know I love sharing my analytics, and I'm very much so an analytical person, but I think I more so get really excited when a video's launched and I see how many views I can get like within the first half hour, and how many of you are commenting within the first half hour. I get really, really excited with that, and I think I'm more so at the point right now where I love the result. Does that even make any sense? Like, when I launch a YouTube video, I love the launch day, but I haven't been so much in love with like the editing and the process of creating videos. And I think you guys could maybe tell that a little bit. My last few videos, they haven't been my normal jumping around, getting cool shots, trying to do different things. They haven't really been that way. And I think it comes off in my videos that I haven't been as much in love with the process as I was before. So I really want to fall back in love with just the creating process and having fun with making my YouTube videos. End the week with an empty inbox. Guys, this is another thing I'm embarrassed to admit, but ever since the growth of my brand, my inbox, my emails have exploded to the point where I am so overwhelmed with it that I just don't respond to emails. Like, I push it off because I know that there are other things that I need to be spending my time on. And do I think that if I responded to emails, it would help with the growth of my brand? Probably. I'd be able to work with a lot more companies, which right now I'm not even trying to work with companies, but I think I would have a little bit more opportunity. I maybe could be making more money, or I could create a better connection with you guys. But I'm at the point where my emails just completely overwhelm me and I just haven't been responding, and that's absolutely terrible on my part. So I want to get back into the routine that every Friday my email inbox is down to zero, and that's something that I really want to hire an assistant for, because I I mean, for me, I would rather be spending my time on something else. I'm just being honest. Pay off all my credit card debt and student loans. You guys already know that's a goal of mine. Work smarter, not harder. 100%. I used to have a rule for myself that when I was in my office, I had to be working. I couldn't be on Instagram or I couldn't be scrolling through Pinterest or something on my computer. I had to be working. And I think over time, I've kind of gotten a little bit away from that. So I just want to be smarter with my time and not just think sitting in my office is called working, because it's not. It's okay to give up control. This is something that I really stink with, but it is okay to give up control. It is okay to take breaks. You guys know, I mean, I hustle hard for my brand. This is something that I love, so I really look at this as my hobby, and whenever I have free time, I want to be working because I truly do love doing this, but I think there are points where I need to give myself a little bit more of a break, and like when Alex is out of the house, I typically use it as an excuse to work more, but I think I need to take that time more so to get good with myself and do a little bit of self-care, and really, my brand wouldn't be here if I wasn't here, so if I'm not taking care of myself, I'm really not taking care of my brand. So I think that I need to learn to take breaks. And then the last thing that I have on this page is something that I actually wanted to talk to you guys about since my mastermind meeting that I went to. You guys know I filmed a video that was a day in my life, and that was the first mastermind meeting that I had with this group that I'm joining for the next 6 months. But in that meeting, the person that's running the mastermind said this quote, "Different is better than better." And at first I was like, what? Honestly, I was like, excuse you? But it totally makes sense. If you are trying to compete with someone else and if you're trying to be better than someone else, that's really not going to set you apart. Being different from someone else is better than being better than someone else. And that's something that I've really been proud of with my brand. I feel like I am very, very different from other people in this niche. And I've set myself apart in so many different ways, but being different has really gotten me to the point where I'm at today. And I need to continue to remember that being myself, creating the videos that I want to create and the process that I have, that's what sets me apart. And it's not me being better than someone else. You know, I think that's a terrible mentality to have, is that competition. Oh, I need to be better. I need to be better. Even if it's competition with yourself or someone else, I just don't think that that is really healthy. At least I know from my own experience, it's not healthy for me. So I just want to focus on being different, creating unique things for you guys, and just having fun with it. So different is better than better. I absolutely love that. I'm very, very excited for this year. I've got a lot of great content coming for you guys. And actually the next video is going to be my December analytic report. And I'm really going to be talking about what ended up happening with me uploading 5 days in 1 week. Do you actually get more followers, more views, more money by uploading more? So I'm very excited for that video and I think you guys are going to like it. So make sure you subscribe to my channel down below. If you guys like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Not all of my videos are super chatty like this, even though I feel like a lot have been recently. And I think you guys are liking some of these a little bit more just because I'm a little bit more unfiltered. You know, it's a little bit more raw and real. So I do incorporate these every now and then, but otherwise we are strategic and I've got some good information to share with you this year. So I'm very, very excited. If you guys have any videos you would like to see in 2020, please let me know in the comment section down below. I've been asking you guys on Instagram as well as in my community tab for your input on some ideas. So make sure you guys let me know your video ideas so I can put them on the content calendar and create them for you. But that is it with this video. I'm so excited to see what you guys are gonna achieve in 2020, what my brand is gonna do this year. And make sure if you guys need help with setting goals that you get the Blow It Up blueprint, because this thing will really help you out a lot. But that is it with this video. I'm out of here. Bye guys. I've got a keyboard, which I totally just missed. And I wanna set goals will really help you all out. Whoa. Recently, my door just locked. I wanna get back in the routine that every Friday, I'm out of here, bye. What?